I can't believe this is actually happening. Oasis are getting back together.
Me and him are like telepathic, you know what I mean?
I know my brother better than anybody else.
When both come together, you have greatness. Made people feel something that was indefinable. Do it all again in a fucking heartbeat. This is it. This is happening. People will never ever forget the way that you made them feel.
All the clues were coming out earlier in the week. There was talk of Liam Gallagher. Oh, I've broken my hand, by the way. Liam Gallagher dedicating a song to Noel effing Gallagher at Reading.
I want to dedicate this next song to Noel f Gallagher.
No!
Half the World Away, which he has dedicated to him before. But then there was this date reveal in the Oasis font with the announcement date, and then 8 a.m. Make sure you tune in. And it does seem like what many fans thought would never ever have happened has happened after 15 years. Now my story is that I became quite a big Oasis fan when I was at university, basically. I would say from 2008, 2009, I did a classical music degree, so my sound world was very much not hard rock, Mozart and Bach and all that stuff. But suddenly, friends at university said, well, you seem to like Jimi Hendrix and all that, why don't you check out Guns N' Roses? So I bought their greatest hits, and Oasis, Stop the Clocks, which is a kind of greatest hits selection album put together by Noly Noly. And it kind of blew my mind. Like the wall of sound hits you in the face. You've got Rock and Roll Star and just Don't Look Back in Anger, The Master Plan, so many great tracks. I love The Master Plan. It's probably my favourite. And it just, I don't know, it was such an exciting sound that I'd never heard that I thought, right, we're going to go and see them. We're going to, they were headlining V Festival on one of the days in Chelmsford in 2009. So we bought tickets, dragged all my friends along. You know, I think I was getting into Guitar Hero at the time, so we were in the Guitar Hero tent for a bit because I was just in the early days of learning to play guitar then. We ate a hot dog that was called the Mega Jumbo, all in preparation to see Oasis. And we got to the stage and there was this kind of rumours were flying around because they were delayed and the internet wasn't really such a, you know, people didn't have Twitter and you couldn't really check to see what was going on very easily. Signal's bad enough as it is nowadays at festivals, but basically the word came out that they weren't going to play. There'd been some problem, like Liam had lost his voice or something like that. So Snow Patrol stepped in and took the headline slot, and then they covered Champagne Supernova, I remember. I think they did one other. I think they also did Don't Look Back in Anger. I can't remember the second track they did. But it was like a big sort of letdown for me because I'd never seen them. And obviously, up until this announcement, I still haven't seen Oasis play. I have seen Noel Gallagher on his own, which is very good. He played a lot of Oasis tracks, but very excited. I wish they'd given us a bit more notice, though, to get the money together to buy a stadium ticket. It's like 5 days to try and think, can I afford that? But I'll try and go. I'll try and drag Lee along to come with me. I mean, I saw Lady Gaga, so it's only fair that she sees Oasis with me. So exciting news. If you're excited, let me know down there. I'm hoping this is going to get better so I can teach you more Oasis tracks. We've got Songbird, though, which we did not so long ago. One of the easy ones to start off with if you're a beginner. Anyway, thanks for checking this out. Hopefully see you at the Oasis gig. Peace out.